leaving IREF women section. At the front office of the IREF women section, there is a frame which talks about hijab. If you can just read it in detail, inshallah, it will give you more inputs about the subject. But now that you have asked the question, and you have asked a very important question related to the contemporary times of certain Muslim girls and Muslim sisters and Muslim women who do not give importance to hijab, and if somebody is wearing hijab, there are those who are not wearing proper kind of hijab. First of all, let us understand what hijab actually means in Islam. The Arabic word hijab, it means to curtain something, to put something in front of another thing, to curtain it so that it is not seen from the other side. That is what is hijab in Arabic. Now, those people who want to linguistically argue about the Quran, these people, they say the word hijab is not mentioned in the Quran. Fine, don't call it hijab. I also say don't call it hijab. But still Allah mentions about covering of the women. Allah says in Surah Nur, Surah number 24, ayat number 31, and Surah Ahzab, Surah number 33, ayat number 59. Two places Allah gives the command that a woman must cover herself from head to toe. Now, what is the ayat, sister? You said decent clothing. A simple question. I am very sure you are a Muslim sister. Are you there at the mic, sister? Yeah, sister, can you just tell me one thing? Do you think our Ummahatul Mumineen, meaning the wives of Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, who are the mothers of the believers, and daughters of Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, like Fatima Razi Allahu Ta'ala and others, do you think that they wore decent clothes or indecent clothes, Nauzubillah?
Decent clothes.
Can you think of better modesty than them in any other Muslim woman? Can there be any Muslim girl or Muslim woman of our time who is more modest, more hayadar than the wives of Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam and his daughters?
No.
Now look at the ayat. Allah says in Surah Ahzab, Surah number 33, ayat number 59. Allah says, "A'udhu billahi minash shaitanir rajim. Ya ayyuhan nabi." There are many ayat in the Quran, about more than 6,000 ayat. Very few in which directly Allah specifically addresses Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. And this is one of them. Allah says, Ya ayyuhan nabi, O nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Qul, say, see, Qul huwallahu ahad, say, Qul in Arabic means say, command, Qul li azwajika, say to your wives, azwaj is from zawja, zawja means spouse, azwaj means spouses. The spouse of a man is his wife. Say to your wives, Qul li azwajika, wa banatika, bint, bin in Arabic means son. Bint means daughter. Banat means plural of bint. Daughters. Ya ayyuhan. Look at the ayat, sister. Ya ayyuhan nabi. O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. O nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Qul li azwajika. Say to your wives. Wa banatika. And to your daughters. Wa nisa'il mu'mineen. And say, nisa means women. Mu'mineen Muslim. And say to the Muslim women. Yudnina alayhinna jalabi behinna. Say to them to cover their garments with an upper garment. In Arabic, if you go and check the Arabic dictionary, jilbab is referred to a covering that is taken over your clothes, not the clothes itself, sister. You got my point, sister? You said are decent clothing enough? So the ayat is jalabi behinna, yudnina alayhinna jalabi behinna. Say to them to cover their clothes with a garment from top to bottom. You got my point, sister?
Yeah.
Jilbab is something which is worn over the clothes. Jalabi behinna from top to bottom. Now, can you imagine in the ayat, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, sister, I want you to reply me. In the ayat, what did Allah say, O Muhammad Sassam? Say to your, can you repeat with me, sister? Whom did Allah command Muhammad Sassam to say to first? Say to your?
Wife.
No, I want the sister to reply there.
Wife.
To the wives. Meaning, wives means Aisha, Hafsa, Sauda, you have Juwairia, you have all these Ummahatul Mumineen, great Ummahatul Mumineen, Aisha Razi Allah Ta'ala, our mother, the daughter of Abu Bakr Siddiq Razi Allah Ta'ala. So Allah is commanding Muhammad Sallam to say to Ummahatul Mumin. After them, whom did he Allah command? Sister, please tell me.
Their daughters.
The daughters. You mean Fatima Razi Allah Ta'ala Anha, Bibi Ruqayya, Bibi Umme Kulsum, Bibi Zainab. Right, sister?
Yes.
Whom is Allah asking these women to cover in front of?
Other men.
Who are those other men, sister, at that time? Sister, they are men of the caliber of Abu Bakr and Umar radiallahu ta'ala. Allah is saying to the wives and daughters of Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam that even if you go in front of the people of the Iman of Abu Bakr and Umar, you will cover yourself. You cannot go without covering yourself. Do you find any man who is equal to Abu Bakr and Umar in our society today, sister?
No.
You can never?
No.
Then look at the ayat. After the wives and the daughters who were commanded to wear the hijab, sister?
All the women.
All the Muslim women, right?
Yeah.
These Muslim women are said that if you come in front of Muhammadur Rasulullah, you will cover yourself and come. You cannot come without covering yourself. Can you imagine how serious is the subject of hijab in Islam? Allah is saying that even in front of Muhammadur Rasulullah, you Muslim women cannot come. And today we say, oh, we are cousins. We don't have that feeling. Saleh hijra hai. What are you? Are you namard? Are you an inanch? See, people say, don't use these words. What shall I use? Allah is commanding Bibi Fatima, Bibi Aisha to wear hijab, and you say, I don't feel like this for my cousin sister. What do you feel? You don't have feelings? Go to a doctor for a checkup. Astaghfirullah. And there is no question of feeling and no feeling now. The Quran didn't say, if you have lustful feeling, then cover it. What are you trying to say? Allah is talking about Nabi Akareem sallallahu alaihi wasallam and saying to the Sahabiyat, even if you come in front of my Nabi, come covered. Can there be anybody better than Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam on earth? How can we dare say then this is such a serious subject? You can't imagine this. Then the face, the arms and the feet, they can be left uncovered. They are not obligatory. They can be. Doesn't mean it is encouraged. When can they be left? The Quran defines again. Allah says in Surah Nur, Surah number 24, ayat number 31, قُلْ لِلْمُؤْمِنَاتِ, say to the Muslim women, they shall lower their gaze, guard their modesty, meaning they should not commit zina, and they shall not show their beauty, zinat. The Arabic word zinat means the moment any sister applies talcum powder, wears a nose ring, applies mehndi or paint or any decoration on the hand, it's fard to cover it now. It's obligatory, farz now. There is no condition of can I, can, can't I. Quran says the moment you apply zinat, cover it. What is zinat? Anything over your natural beauty you apply, you need to cover it. This is how serious Quran is about hijab. All the historical books about the time of Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam and his wives, the moment this ayat was revealed, Bibi Aisha, Sahih al-Bukhari, she says, if you read Tafsir Ibn Kasir for this, you will find Bibi Aisha, she says, the moment this ayat was revealed, we pulled the curtains from our homes and we wrapped ourselves with those curtains. We didn't even wait to say, Ya Rasulullah, we don't have hijab, we don't have a cloth, what shall we do? Look at the severity. They pulled the curtains from the doors and they wrapped around themselves. Hijab. About the beard, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is the best example to mankind. Allah says in Ahzab surah number 33 ayat number 21, laqad kana lakum fi rasulillahi uswatun hasana. The best example for mankind is in Muhammadur Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. If you read Sahih al-Bukhari volume number 7, hadith number 5892, narrated by Umar radiyallahu ta'ala anhu, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, grow your beard and trim your mustaches. This is the command of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Those young brothers who think, are sunnat hai na, kya hota nahi kare to. I always tell these brothers, if you are standing in front of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam when he is commanding this and saying, grow your beard, and you don't grow it, next time you come in front and Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, what happened? Where is your beard? And you reply, oh, see, Nabi sallam, this is not farzna, this is not in the Quran, this is what you said in the sunnat, so I didn't grow it. Can you say that to him? When you can't say that to him on the face, just because he is not with us here, you are daring to comment on a hadith of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And you know, there was a recent survey done. Women are more attracted towards men with beard. Today it has become a fashion now. Now the fashion is growing beard. So the people have started to grow beard. The beard, it prevents you from skin cancer. There is a list of diseases that can come to you and they get prevented with the beard. Not my research. This is a research from Harvard University, USA. So, how important is beard? For us, all these researches are secondary. For us, our Nabi said, this is Samena Watana. We heard and we obeyed. That's it for us. Kalu Samena Watana. We heard and we obey. With this, I would like to conclude the talk. Allah.